Hello and welcome to Market Watch for the start of the week of the 11th of December 2017. The week is here. It is going to be a ginormous week for macroeconomic data. I'm going to concentrate just on the FOMC for this. There's a lot of implied inflection points. There's a lot of actual market moving interesting points. And there's a very Australian-centric thing about it as well that I'll bring to. I will highlight very quickly there are other parts of this week that you need to be aware of. Thursday, you've got our employment data has been very, very strong, and I continue to expect that to be the case. Tuesday also is my EFO, and that budget update from the government will be interesting. Very much keep an eye on their current expectations and average pricing for bulk commodities. They are under, that is clear. The question is how much that's added to the budget bottom line. But we'll leave that, and we will certainly talk about that as a special on Tuesday. Therefore, let's look at what happens on Wednesday night, Thursday morning for us here in Australia and around the FOMC. We know they're going to raise rates in December. If they didn't do it, I actually think there'd be a bigger, more cataclysmic movement in the market than if they do. It's all baked in. It is clearly priced in. The difference now is that you've got a Fed chair who is clearly now, you know, on the out. Janet Yellen, in my personal point of view, has been fantastic. Her communication's been great. And she is completely stepping away, which I think is a very clever thing to do, to give Jerome Powell complete fresh air. So anything she says may now not be as probably influential as it could have been. But in saying that, there are so many points to look at from a market perspective that come out of this meeting. Do the dot plots change? Having a look at the current numbers and having a look at the current expectations, there are still three in there. Will that shift? I don't think it will, but having a look into February, that might be the case. Again, looking at the market, and you can see very clearly that the market still believes that the Fed is overestimating where they're going to see rates at the back end of the year. You can see on this chart coming out of the CME that expectations for rates between 1.75 and 2% are sitting at 38%. So that means there's only 1.5 rate rise expectations by this time next year baked into it. What's also getting interesting, and I'm sure you've heard a lot about it, is coming up with what this chart is here. And you can see at the moment, the concern is around the 2 and 10 year bond rates. So the sovereign rates in the US are actually what we call flattening, and there is actually now a steepening at the front end of the curve. So 2 years is going to cost you about 1.75% on a yield, and it's getting even higher still, and it probably will leading into that meeting where the 10 year isn't moving at all. It's around about 2.3%. The catch with that and why it's such an issue is that it means front-end funding is becoming quite expensive, and people therefore are moving their funding to the back end. That can create some gaps that can create liquidity issues. And you can see on that chart as well that the current rate is just above that, but it's really ratcheted up and moved away from the target rate, which currently sits at 1.5. With that in mind, the other side, and bringing back to an Australian-centric point of view, is that for the first time in 18 years, we're now looking down the barrel of seeing US rates the same as Australian rates, and it's very, very likely that in 2018, it will actually surpass it. The interesting thing about that is that it brings back twofold from an Australian-centric point of view again. That is clearly a structural decliner for the Aussie dollar. We are one of the best nations for carry trade. And what I mean by that, for those that don't get carry trade, it's where you can borrow in one country for very cheap, turn it to a country like us, get the yield out of it, and then repatriate it back. The Japanese are the best at this, and it's the currency I'd probably watch. The Aussie yen is the one here, because if all of a sudden the carry trade transfers to the US and they get better rates in the US with a growing economy, a more stable economy, and the US being what it is, money will outflow out of our country, and therefore to do that, you have to sell your Aussie dollars and buy whatever currency that is. Clearly in this state, it's going to be the US dollar. That will push the Aussie lower. It also creates a bit of a funding problem as well in terms of what goes on the wholesale side of lending in this country. I've spoken about this many times. We know that the banks have to go to the wholesale market to actually fund what they do. If you see rates moving up and then also a falling Aussie dollar and a differential in our rate, it makes a bit more of an expense. Do they try and actually start funding from Australia? We know there isn't enough funding here. All of that is the conundrum that comes into it. And that's why the FOMC is such a big deal for not just the US, but for the globe, because clearly a raising US interest rate is a positive for their economy. It shows that they're growing. It's still very much on the accommodative side. But, and that's the big thing here, but it does start to create interesting pockets, interesting dilemmas for our market as well. So that is what you need to look at on Thursday morning. The rates will go up. What are their expectations around next year? What does it mean for us? Watch that Aussie dollar very closely. And therefore the question becomes, does it become to a point where funding gets tougher? That'll be the question for 2018.